Get ready to match the stars from the Rockford Files, Joe Santos, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Angie, Donna Pascal, Bill Daly, and Patty Lou Gaston as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rammer.
Okay, thank you for joining us. Hello there. And how do you do?
And how do you do? Going to Hawaii, eh, for your vacation?
Just got back.
Just got back. Mm-hmm. You like it there?
Aloha.
Goodbye.
Aloha Nui.
Aloha. I just got back from Scotland.
Oh, you did?
Toodaloo.
I don't want you to think he's gone crazy
or anything.
Right,
because you're wearing something in...
He asked me if I liked the print. I said, darling, it's a plaid.
Yes, it is.
And I suppose you just got back from the Reuben Brothers warehouse.
Over here we have Mike Wynn and Patty Spurgeon. Now let's see. Patty, you're from?
Knoxville, Tennessee.
Knoxville, Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
And you're a student?
Uh-huh, at the University of Tennessee.
Right.
And I like to play tennis, remember?
Yes, that's right. I've offered to challenge you, right. You're vacationing out here.
Mm-hmm. I'm seeing my brother.
Yeah.
Charlie's out there.
Where is he? Raise your hand.
Second row.
That lady is your brother?
I'm here with my mother.
Where?
She's right next door.
Oh.
There she is. See her?
Oh, I see him. Okay. Just want to make sure everything's under control. Mike Wynn, a fireman.
Right.
From Ventura. I mean from Ojai, whose company is located in Ventura.
Correct.
Ojai is a very beautiful community here in California, for those of you who are not familiar with it. There's a scene when I was there visiting. We drove up to a little mountain nearby. Don't walk out again.
I was thinking about it. Along.
No, I want to tell you, there's this wonderful little... You go up in the outskirts of Ojai, and you drive up this high hill, and you look down into the valley, and that is the place from which the cameras were located when they did Lost Horizons, a wonderful motion picture. That, you know, that shot of the valley. There was this beautiful shot. There's a beautiful shot of the valley. The camera was way up here. Up here, looking down on this wonderful green valley. This green valley.
It's laying there, honey. Your travelogue is laying.
I wasn't going to work the story. Let's hear it for Gene Rammer.
Okay, well, the hell with you. I'm getting out of here. That's all the way you appreciate me.
What do I do back here?
Oh, I see. Okay, ready to play. All right, here we go. Starting in the middle of round one. Oh, yeah, we started the second game, didn't we? And you had your first question, match one star, and Mike Wynn from this beautiful valley in Ojai.
Tell us about that hill.
Jim said it's weird living next to a nuclear plant. I don't use my oven anymore. I just put the food in my blank.
My broken knee, too, for this show.
Is your knee better?
No.
Is it bruised?
It's terminal.
She hurt her knee on yesterday's show or the day before.
No,
okay. Mike, Jim said it's weird living next to a nuclear plant. I don't use my oven anymore. I just put the food in my...
I think it was cupboard.
Cupboard?
Yeah. Get the raise from the plant,
Michael,
you know.
Michael.
I'm losing it.
Blew that one.
I missed the point on that one, I think.
That's right.
Well, you got that beautiful place to go back to.
Okay, Joe, what do you say?
this is just as dumb. Atomic reactor.
Joe, you
I mean, why not? I mean... So,
Joe.
Come here, dear.
Joe.
But it's not bad.
It's very bad.
You gotta think about what I'm thinking about.
No, here's the thing.
Don't explain it to him.
I will explain it to you. A nuclear plant in some characteristics has the aspects of a microwave oven.
But listen.
Therefore, if you're living that next door to a giant microwave oven, you just put the food in your...
In Ojai, they have atomic reactors in everybody's homes.
They do?
You put your food in your backyard and wait to die.
Well, I can see we're in for a very cheerful day here.
I wouldn't pick a fight with an Italian, if you know what I mean.
Can I do my dissertation on nuclear plants?
No. What do you say for an answer here?
I say that the Ojai bus schedule is 12:14. Be sure to go on top, and you made a redundant. You said up on the high hill.
There's no such thing as a redundant.
It's a redundancy.
Well, that's what you did anyway.
Better still.
And I chose mailbox.
Mailbox.
Okay. Just put the food in my mailbox. That's not bad.
I live next door to a nuclear plant. I don't use my oven anymore. I just put the food in my...
Window.
Window.
And wait to die.
Michael Wind is now Michael Lose. Mine was mouth. I don't even know what that means.
That's very good.
I would think that would be the definitive answer there.
Mouth?
Yeah.
Your mouth comes to your body.
Your whole body becomes radioactive from the nuclear power plant. Well, not right away. You have three or four, you know, you're allowed one meal.
Of course,
long enough to digest.
Does everyone here know how to pronounce nuclear?
Nuclear.
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 It always surprises me when the president of these United States says nuclear.
He does say it.
He do.
And he's a nuclear scientist, too. Nothing personal, Jimmy. But you got to learn how to talk. You've got to be president of the United States here. Okay. Miss Patty? Yeah.
You put it in your window box next to your radioactive geraniums.
Uh-huh. All right, and everybody cooks together. Okay, let's go to round two. Patty, you're ahead. We'll ask you to go first.
I'll take B again.
B again? Well, girl from Tennessee wants B.
That's the piano teacher. I remember that.
As Freddie the Fireman.
Oh, that is
Freddie the Fireman lay on the floor, all black and blue. He said, okay, who blanked the pole? Okay. As Freddie the Fireman lay on the floor, all black and blue, he said, okay, who blanked the pole?
Grease.
Grease. Being from the deep south, she said greased. Us northerners, we say greased.
Yeah, she came very close to being Italian on that one.
Greased. Greased the pole. Okay, you got two. What do you got for the lady?
I have something she's going to really like. She's from South, so I greased.
That's a good poem. Okay, Chuck.
I didn't go that route, Gene. I went another route altogether. I said, who moved the
pole? Who moved the pole? Geronimo! That's a funny picture, yes.
See, it's a match. It's just a different word, oiled.
Oiled and greased. Yep, that is true. He didn't write this round.
I wasn't supposed to write, so I just put an empty card in there.
Okay. Thank you for your cooperation. Okay. Now, Patty Duke.
Yes. Who greased the pole with parquet?
Who greased the pole? Okay. Five for her. You got one shot at it. First, I'm going to do a little message for America. Okay? Watch this, please.
You know what
all right.
Do?
Now, Mike, last chance. 5 to tie, 6 to win. For old Mike.
Oh, I didn't realize.
Oh, hi.
By the way,
Oh, hi. Now stop plugging that light.
Here we go. The Galloping Gourmet said.
Sorry.
Got a lot of kids in your house. You're always doing that to you, huh? And now you want to do it to somebody else.
Yep.
Okay. The Galloping Gourmet said, today I am preparing a dish that will make anyone gallop. The main ingredient is...
I got it! Oh, baby, have I got it!
Well, I don't want it! Okay. The Galloping Gourmet said, today I'm preparing a dish that will make anyone gallop. The main ingredient is...
Ex-lax.
Ex-lax?
I think that would be unkind of him to do that.
This is close to ex-lax, though.
I see. Okay. All right. Now you got to match everybody else here to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Mike, what do you say, Brett?
Oh, Mike, I'm sorry.
Just show the card, dear.
It's beans. Beans, the musical fruit.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, that means Penny wins the game. What everybody else has.
It's right? Her for beans.
That's right. Mike is leaving here with $5,500 and our best wishes. Say hello to everybody in Ohio. Okay. Now, all this is for your benefit, Patty. Good luck to you. Here we go. We polled a studio audience and we said, write down your best answer to this. A piece of blank.
Oh, boy.
If you match the answer that they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And for matching the third, $100. And you get some answers from them, and I'll see you a little bit later here. Okay, who do you call on first?
Brett.
What I always get, a piece of the action.
Piece of the action, all right.
And Charles?
Charles, what do you say?
Don't say it. We'll have to go to black.
A piece of pie.
Okay, that's two.
Okay, and Patty.
A piece of cake.
Cake, pie, and action. You want one of those? Which one?
I'll take cake.
You'll take cake?
Yeah, they call me Patty Cake at home.
She says they call her Patty Cake at home, so she wants cake.
Oh, dear.
Okay. Want to play a little game of Patty Cake? No, I guess you better not. Okay, let's see if we have a piece of cake up there somewhere. May we see the $100 number? A piece of the action was Brett's answer there at the $100 number. At the $250 level, we have... piece of pie.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
By Jove, I think she's going to be right.
Oh, my goodness.
Last chance for a piece of cake. Go.
Please.
Yeah. Very good judgment. Now, Patty, you've got $500. It means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But you're going to spin the star wheel, and if you get a lucky spin, you'll double it and play for $10,000. Good luck to you, my dear. We'll all root for a double. Here we go for a double for Patty. Go.
Wait a minute.
See what she's trying to do? She's trying to. And it wouldn't spin. Last spin it now. Just grab one of these pegs.
Give it a good one, sweetheart. Go.
There we go.
Let's double it up. Let's double it up. Good as there.
Face me. Here we go. Good luck to you. You did it.
Get it right.
You are playing for $10,000 with Bill Daly. He's going to write an answer. You'll give me a verbal response. Here it is. Bubbling brank. Brank.
Brank.
Bubbling blank.
Are you Oriental?
Yes. Okay, now Bill has written his answer. You think about it, and if you give us the same answer he has in the card, you get $10,000. Bubbling.
Bubbling bath?
Bubble bath is what I usually say, but you say bubbling bath? Mom, hand me that bottle of bubbling bath, Adam. All right, Bill, she says bubbling bath.
I'm sorry, I lost my kiss and the girl and the hug, and I said champagne. I'm sorry.
Bubbling champagne. Oh, the golden giving a kiss anyway. He tried for you, didn't he? Right. Sorry you didn't get the $10,000 there. Bubbling champagne was not a bad answer. What else was there?
Another dumbass.
Bubbling brook is a very good one. Very good. Babbling Brook. You thought of that and rejected. Yeah. Babbling Brook. I think you're right. All right, we'll get another game going here a little bit later. Right now, we want to do this message just for you. All right, let's welcome our new players now. Here comes Pat Stewart and Narana Pogue. Yeah. Hello there, ladies. We welcome both of you. Rimani, you'll each play two games, and we want to find out who you are and get acquainted with you before we start. Pat, tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm a directory assistance operator for a major telephone company. I'm single, but I do have a boyfriend.
Oh, thank God.
And I like bowling and river running.
Yeah. So, cooler. All right. And Narana?
Yes. Perfect.
Where are you from?
I'm on my way to Maryland. I've been here for 4 years, but I'm leaving an aspiring interior designer, going back to a smaller market.
Yeah.
And I am married with two children and one on the way.
Okay. Good luck to both ladies. We'll begin by asking Pat to make a selection.
B, please.
All right. It's yours. It says, Unlucky Louie said, I have the world's worst luck. All my friends keep falling in love. Me, I just keep falling in blank. I have the world's worst luck. All my friends keep falling in love. Me, I just keep falling in blank. Remember, it's the first round question. What the heck? Anything else.
Do we get to vote on the questions?
If you want, yeah.
Get it in there, babe.
Okay, Pat. Yeah. Lucky Louie said, I have the world's worst luck. All my friends keep falling in love. Me, I just keep falling in...
holes.
Holes is good. Perfectly wonderful answer. Walking along the street, falls in a hole. What's wrong with that, Joe?
I was going to say money, because that made more sense to me, but I said manholes.
Manholes. Okay, one for her. All right, one for Pat.
See how the little devil thinks? You said unlucky Louie.
Yeah.
So he said falling...
money. In... love and money.
Love and money.
Unlucky in love.
God, I'd love to be inside his brain.
Yes. Manholes.
I think he's been out in the sun too much. I said, I said potholes and or regular holes.
Okay, that's another one for Pat.
I said the same thing as Joseph. We both come from New York. However, I had diction lessons and a bummer.
Open manhole.
Bad joke.
Okay. I don't think you heard. Did you hear what Charles said? Can you hear what I'm saying, do you?
Yeah. What? But I'm sorry to hear.
They didn't hear you, Charles.
Oh. You're just as well off.
Let's just make sure the audience PA system is operating functionally so that when Charles says something amusing, everybody can hear it. Thank you very much. Okay.
I'm real embarrassed. I'd rather you just go on.
Okay.
Well, I'm really embarrassed, so go back there. Then.
We're back to you, Donna.
Back to you again, Eric.
Where are you from? Where's she from?
She's from, she lives here now. No, Pat is from, where are you from?
Originally Illinois, but I make my home in Lamont.
Well, now, I'm from New York also, and like the two gentlemen up there, when I think of accidentally falling into something, don't have manholes to
you have money.
Dog poop.
Darling.
I've ruined an entire career in one
holy
swift card.
Mackerel, yeah. They've got a law now in New York.
Hooper Scooper.
No, we're not. That's going to go along with the Ojai Valley story if you go into that.
No, it's not. All right, Bill.
Well, see, this unlucky guy was in the Army, see, and he just kept falling in, which is doesn't make any sense at all.
He just kept falling in.
He just...
What does it say? Just falling in.
Yeah, see, it's an error.
I'll feel really bad until I heard those two.
Yeah. Yeah, anything you say has got to look good alongside Bill Daly.
Well, it doesn't look good, but it's not as bad as I thought it was. Well, I thought of mud puddles.
Falling in mud.
Holes, as the case may be.
All right. So that's three for her, and Narana, let's see what we've got for you.
Good.
Let's have a commercial, and we'll put this back here. It's the end, right?
Right.
This is the end. Goodbye. Join us tomorrow for Match Game. Gene Rayburn here. Thank you.
Some of our contestants will receive from Panamex a 35 microflash camera, so small it fits in the palm of the hand. Built-in electronic flash, three settings, thumb wheel film advance, exposure counter from Panamex. And Boisel presents this hand-blown crystal lamp from the Satin Lace Collection, designed to add beauty and warmth to your home exclusively by Boisel Lighting. and Arauco's new 1200-watt professional-style hair dryer. Lightweight, two-temperature airflow speed settings for styling and drying from Arauco. And gas-saving Quaker State Sterling Motor Oil, specially blended to help save gas and money. You'll be staying on the road with Quaker State. And Ultra Super Glue handles hundreds of household gluing needs quickly and efficiently. It's another fine product from the laboratories of Ross Chemical Company.